Aiden, tell me what you're up to right now.
I'm so. Hold on. Wait.
Okay. Take.
I'm sewing my trousers for holiday. Woo! This is genuinely. Every time I sew something, I'm like, this is the worst thing I've ever sewn. Because I've like done it recently with a bunch of my trousers. Because you shouldn't let your hike get in the way.
No, you shouldn't let your height get in the way of anything.
So.
There's actually, so there's lots of Caribbean islands that we couldn't visit because there was a height restriction. You must be this tall to enter. That was just there. So that's why we're not going to St. Lucia. Because, yeah, they don't allow hobbits, unfortunately. So half an hour into the big Caribbean trip and we're getting some Caribbean weather. Hopefully we don't look back and think, oh, we only had our only half an hour of decent weather in Costa Rica was just after we got out of the plane. Okay, morning number one in Costa Rica, and it has dawned spectacular, and we are fucking buzzing. I'm not gonna lie. We're very happy. Although our first destination, which is a waterfall, we've just driven past. That's the road we've just driven down. There's nothing to see, so we think that we need to head down into this valley. I don't know if that's going to be audible on the recording, but it sounds like there's a waterfall down there. So then the question is, how do we get down there? Okay, we're on our way to Los Churros waterfall. God, it is steep down there. I can hear the waterfall. Can you?
Mum, if I die on this trip, tell everyone I got a first at university.
Oh my God, it's actually broken. It's actually a broken rope bridge. Fucking hell. Come and have a look. Check ahead.
Hi, my name's Eden Underwood. Welcome to the seven most dangerous animals.
I still don't think you've seen it, Eden. It's broken.
Hi, we are at Los Churros volcano. No, we are at Los Churros waterfall. We have just walked down a really quite intense hill.
You can just see the canopy up there. We basically started higher than that and then came all the way down, really steep path.
And we're a little bit sweaty now, so going the other way up is gonna be really quite something.
It makes me feel very, it's a very visceral experience, it's very human. It's, you know, we're so detached in this modern age from everything real. And everything physical. Mm. And right now you could say that we are reconnecting to the physical.
Yeah. We spent breakfast today with a very alternative American gentleman who told us about astral cartography and how someone had tracked his kind of friendship, career, health lines around the world and then pinpointed the geographical areas where it was most beneficial for him. Because he had health problems, he came to Costa Rica and that's where he ended up. And
I trashed him.
A little bit skeptical. No, he asked, he did say, do you believe in astrology? And you said, I think you said, I'm not sure. You didn't say, no, it's bullshit.
Said, not really.
He definitely liked us, so I don't think we offended him. But yeah, so we've got alternative medicine on land.
He's cursing us because he does.
Well, if he's cursing us for this, then he can curse away.
But he was very nice. His name's Don. He's from Colorado. He
no, I didn't.
They're just vibing.
At the moment it's about 6 in the morning, day 2. Haven't quite overcome the jet lag yet.
We've run out of food. We have 2 cans of sardines left.
We have
shipwrecked.
And not conquered the jet lag.
Don't know what fucking time it is.
But to be honest, when the mornings are like this, and we wake up at 5, it's probably worth it. Main pool. Volcano view. That's about as much as we've seen of it so far. And then the brown water, don't let it put you off because it's boiling.
Like, yeah, man.
Is there a reason why he bobs his head?
He's bobbing to attract the female.
Oh, right.
The female is around it, we don't see it.
But he knows that she's close.
See?
Interesting.
He knows that what she likes.
Well, I don't know if you can hear us at all, but right now we are at a wet bar. See this? We're at Baldy Resort, Pete Underwood, eat your heart out. We got here at 9 o'clock this morning. It's about 4:30 now, still here, showing no signs of flagging. I'm incredibly happy, I'm not gonna lie. It's been up there in top 20 days of my life, probably. Considering, you know, not that many things have actually happened. I mean, basically nothing has happened. The most traumatic thing that's happened was a big water slide. There is about 25 different pools here. Water slides that nearly break your neck, give you a heart attack. There's not even many people around. The whole place is just like basically empty. There's a few people at this bar right now, and that's the most people you've seen at once all day.
Yeah.
We are leaving Arenal Volcano tomorrow, although we're not going far. Eden, thoughts on Arenal Volcano so far? Even though we haven't seen it.
I like how it looks out the window. I like being in the presence of a volcano. Quite exciting. I think La Patina as a place is a bit meh.
Yeah.
When I found a pool, like artisan crafting shop, that made me very happy. Like that. It's nice here. Cleared away, I liked our experiences on the first proper day just because it felt more.
Yeah. I mean, this is a beautiful place and it's quite unique, but you can do stuff like this more or less anywhere. And I was saying to Eden that I love it here, but at the same time, you feel a little bit like Lord of the Manor upstairs, downstairs, because they're kind of the Costa Rican people serving you. Yeah, okay. Over and out. I'm on it, get on it. The chips are on fire, you know I need it. Much closer, I'm treading just a little. Must step on it.
electronic. The troops are on fire. I'm much deeper, a sleeper. I'm waiting for the final trip.
We've had a good day.
We have, yeah.
Well, more or less.
I can't remember anything bad about it.
We were out this morning. we're not going to talk about that anymore. That's old news. On our way to stop number 3, and we stopped at a little restaurant and we had some nachos.
It was like the most beautiful place.
Yeah, but I'm more concerned with the food. Yeah, it was. It was really nice. It's like a garden that looked over a lake, a really big lake, and there's like blue mountains in the distance and 80s music.
And aside from that place, there was almost nothing at all around, like looking over the lake. It was like if the Italian lakes were just completely untouched. I've been to so many beautiful places, but there's always been a fair amount of people around, even if it's just like the occasional farm.
And that's not what it's like here. There's so much space and there's so much green, and so much of it is so like it lush and un. Oh my god!
Fuck. Okay, for you viewers at home, that's like the third dog that's just strolled out into the road in front of us.
All
today.
Of the dogs have death wishes.
Yeah, suicidal dogs are real.
We think it's heaven. The dogs are like, fucking get me out. Any further comments, Benjamin?
Just that we're on our way to the next place, which is Posada Rural, Rio Celeste, something like that.
Yeah.
So the next stop is 2 days by the big famous blue waterfall. Not sure what to expect. The last place was very touristy. I'm hoping it might be a bit less touristy. And that there's stuff to do, because there might just be a waterfall or nothing else. We're now through with our fancy accommodation, so it's taking a bit of a dip for the next week or so.
To be continued.
To be continued. It really, really is, and I am so upset that we can't swim in it.
Yeah, but we can swim in the other bit.
A few moments later.
Well, if you remember that video I took about 20 minutes ago, things have changed. My first thought was, why is this not packed? And it turns out it was just after lunch.
In the car.
Oh, and it's turning off. Buzzing. Oh, you're vlogging? First morning at Samara Beach. It's about 10 o'clock in the morning. It's already at least 30 degrees and scorching.
look at it.
Do you feel like you're being watched?
No.
Not even from above?
God? Last night here, and I honestly don't know how it's our last night here, because 3 nights is longer than the stays that we've mostly done, and yet it's absolutely flown by. We've done a grand total of jack shit in the last couple of days, but it's been glorious, honestly. Probably my favorite place that we've stayed, despite the rest of Costa Rica kind of fulfilling everything that I wanted to see. This place has just been really, really nice. And I think the fact that we've been so busy beforehand made it quite guilt-free to just laze on this beach.
The last hostage here for me, I'm
Eden. Yep. This is effectively a hostage scenario, but Eden's allowing herself to be taken hostage by this town. It's got a beautiful beach, amazing weather, boutiques lining the streets. It's touristy, but doesn't really feel overrun.
It's artsy, there's yoga and writing things and reading, and it's like a timeless place. Fucking warm.
Yeah. Probably the warmest place I've ever been.
Sorry. The clean version. Really quite warm. So I'm worried you're going to show it to your mum and dad to get this one, like, and I'm just like effing and blinding.
Nah.
Hey, Karen and John. How are you?
Hi mum and dad. How's it going? So right now we are on our way between Samara and Monteverde, and it looks like we were taking main roads. Possibly we are, but as ever on our journeys, one of the roads was really quite sketchy. There's an incredible views, but we are riding the ridge of some serious foothills here, and it is quite scary. We are looking for some cute puppies who across the road in front of us. Although they may have gone. Hello.
Hey. Come here. Come here. Hello.
You got your laces.
Boys, come on. No.
Hello.
anything. You don't think you can hold you. Go.
The drive down from Monteverde back to San Jose, and Eden managed to spot a few monkeys. Say goodbye to Costa Rica, Eden. Arrived in Dominican Republic. This is La Isleta on the beach of La Galeras, which is literally just across there. It's about a 1 minute walk and it's absolutely beautiful. The town itself is a little bit more run down, but we've obviously chosen one of the nicest places to stay. It's all immaculate, quite quiet. We obviously are off season here as well, and the pool unfortunately has no water in it. But it's a bit cooler here than Costa Rica and a lot less humid. Outside area. I was doing a voiceover and then I kind of just gave up.
I'm in disgrace because I jumped down the waterfall. How are you feeling right now, Eden?
Itchy. And hungry. And a bit disgusting.
We haven't eaten lunch. We have waterfalled. We've got rained on. And then we've walked half an hour up a sweaty, muddy river. But honestly, I've never been feeling better. If you told me that this level of town would be happening, then I'd have been very happy. And also, we're in a place called Los Pereños, which is what I expected Samaná to be, and it's not.
It's really not.
No.
Two piñas, it's too many piñas. Oh my god! Smurfy.
is that not going to be upside down?
What's up, cool cats and kittens?
What?
You thought the vlogs were over, but actually,
they've just started.
It's our last night here at the Caribbean. This has been a really amazing place.
Constantly looks incredible.
As you can see from my foot camera.
This is a good camera phone, it does the job for me.
Yeah?
Yeah, really.
Sponsored by the Google.
Yeah, go out and buy one.
Now.
Do it. So today we've spent most of the time inside and watching Pirates of the Caribbean. And then coming out here, which has been kind of fun, kind of surreal. I'm glad that we came here, but we sort of shot ourselves in the foot by doing Costa Rica first, because it was just
really... It was never going to measure it out. Costa Rica was just too beautiful and too nice.
And immaculate, like, you know, they're burning rubbish on the side of the road here, and there's nothing massively wrong with that, but it just didn't happen in Costa Rica.
Yeah.
And yeah, people were so unbelievably friendly and nice in Costa Rica, and they've been absolutely fine here, but just a little bit different. So I do feel like if we'd come just here, we wouldn't have thought those thoughts. I don't feel sad right now.
I feel sad.
It's lovely here, but I'm kind of happy to be moving on. I feel like if we were here for 2 weeks, we'd probably run out of things to do. Because it's just so, like, there's lots of stuff to do on the island, but it's like a 7 hour drive away.
Yeah.
And the drives are fucking intense with the...
It's like massive speed bumps. People just walking on the road, dressed in dark colours. People doing nails in the middle of the road. Motorbikes without lights.
Yeah.
Motorbikes to cut you up. Police with like big guns and like skull masks that pull you over.
Yeah.
We basically almost died yesterday. And that was quite terrifying. Oh, bugs. So many bugs.
Got them.
So we're going to go and be in the moment now and watch the sun as it sets.
I think that was thunder, so possibly we'll get rained on too.
And eat some pesto pasta and watch Pirates of the Caribbean and just try not to be sad.
My dream nut.
Bye!
So we've made it to Santo Domingo, capital of Dominican Republic. We haven't quite made it cold. We're both feeling a little bit worse for wear today. So a bit of a gloomy walk through the city. But we have found the first cathedral built by the conquistadors, built by the invaders, in all of the Caribbean. And it is quite beautiful. Feels a little bit... A little bit different. Yeah.
I know that, you know, in a tribe, would be,
do you think she's a tribes person?
Yeah, and she's below.
Oh,
him,
yeah, yeah.
And she's a woman.
Yeah.
She's like writing his name.
Oh, she is, yeah.
And she serves him. He's a white man.
Yeah. But right now he's saying, hey, that looks like India to me.
Currently in Little Italy, this is my favourite part so far. I think this might be my favourite day so far too. We've done quite a lot. I'm going to stop filming now because I feel so nervous.
Famous Wall Street Bull. It looks like the girl standing in its way has gone. Big long line to touch the bollocks and another fairly big line to get a photo at the front. Strangely a less big line. Obviously the bollocks take the biscuit.
And that is that great lesson that we've learned from this trip, ladies and gents. The bollocks take the biscuit. Let's go.
Yeah. Technology's live. We're just about to see Times Square for the first time.
Oh shit!
I don't know. Feels like we're acting a bit weird, but honestly, it could be anything. Sorry to selfie, but can't selfie here. Why can you?
Watching storms, sitting quiet, reading books in the heat of
city. Ian just wants to go clothes shopping.
I do. I really want to just look at clothes.
Thank you.